Welcome to session 5 of biasing in BJT amplifier circuits. In this session, we are going to study about two more related topics to this small signal operations and the models. So they are voltage gain and the hybrid pi models. So therefore, let us start with the voltage gain. Okay, so how to write? Derive the voltage gain for the amplifier in discussion. So we know that the applied input signal is nothing but VBE. Okay, and this VBE produces a proportional collector current, which is given by IC, that is equal to GM into VBE. Okay. So for applied base emitter signal VBE, a proportional collector current that is flowing is given by IC is equal to GM into VBE. Okay. So thereby the BJT acts like a voltage controlled current source. Now this current can be made to flow through a resistor RC. Okay, so that is collector resistor RC, as we have seen in our circuit diagram. So therefore, now we can write the total current, total collector voltage VC. So the total collector current voltage is represented as small VC. Okay, so small V, capital C, because this includes both the DC as well as the signal component. So this will be equal to VCC minus IC into RC. Okay. So this particular equation is written with reference to this part of the circuit, that is at the collector part. So we have RC here and there is a VCC, and next we have the collector terminal. And this is the emitter. Okay. So through collector terminal we have the IC that is flowing. Okay. So therefore we can take this as equation 1. Because using this only, further we are going to derive the total voltage. So therefore some substitution can be done here. We know that this small I capital C is nothing but the combination of DC collector current IC as well as signal component, that is small IC into RC. Okay, so further this VC can be written as VCC minus IC into RC. Group this as one term, because you might be observing here all are DC components only, it is both IC and VCC, and next what we have is small IC and RC. Okay, so therefore this particular part of the total collector voltage, that is VCC minus IC into RC, now can be called as capital VC. Okay, so therefore the above equation it can be rewritten as, so the total collector voltage VC is nothing but capital VC minus IC into RC. So this is one important relation which will be further used in the derivation of gain. Okay. So now the above equation 2, it has two quantities in it in the RHS sign. What are the quantities? The first one is the VC, that is this VC quantity is nothing but the DC bias voltage. It is DC bias voltage at the collector. And similarly, the second part, that is the IC into RC product, IC into RC product is the signal voltage. Is the signal voltage. Okay. So therefore, let us consider this part, that is the signal part, that is VC is equal to minus IC into RC. So now this can be further written in terms of GM also. So minus GM into VBE into RC. This is because IC is equal to GM into VBE, as in the previous session we have derived it. So therefore VC can be now written as minus GM into RC into VBE. Okay, so call it as equation 3, because this gives us one of the important relations, because on the LHS we have V BC, and on the RHS we have VBE. Okay, so BC is nothing but the output voltage, VBE is nothing but the input. Okay, so while taking the gain, we are taking the ratio of these two only. So therefore, now let us define the voltage gain for this amplifier. Therefore, it is written as AV is equal to VC by VBE. VC by VBE. See, you should observe that I am not writing capital VC here. Okay, so if I write capital VC, it corresponds to DC collector voltage. Okay, it doesn't contain any signal component. So therefore, whenever we are writing the total collector voltage, what is our convention of notations is we need to write in small v terms. So it includes both capital VC as well as the signal component. So therefore, now in this equation, we will make some more substitutions. Like VC is nothing but minus GM into RC into VBE, because previously we have derived it. See, VC is equal to minus GM RC into VBE. So equation 3 only I am substituting in the numerator, divided by VBE. So therefore, the VBE component gets cancelled, and we have the gain AV is equal to simply minus GM into RC. Okay. So therefore, this is an important result. Take it as equation 4, which gives the gain of the amplifier. Okay. And also, we have one more expression also for GM. What is that? GM is also equal to IC by VT. Okay. So using this also, we can further write AV equation. Okay. So AV can also be written as minus IC by RC divided by VT. Okay. So therefore, these are the two gain equations we have for the amplifier. Take it as equation 5. Okay. Now in this equation, we can see that AV means that's gain will be directly proportional to IC bias current. So therefore, as long as the bias current is stable, so the gain will be stable. This is what is the conclusion from equation 5. So next, move on to the second topic, that is the hybrid pi model. Now the hybrid pi model, it is just a representation of our amplifier that we have been discussing, and this model it represents this voltage controlled current source. Okay, and the model, it includes input resistance R pi by looking into the base region, and this particular model, it also yields IC as well as IB. That is, the hybrid pi model is the one which includes the resistance R pi. Okay, what is this input resistance by looking into the base region, and also the model also will give us IC, which is nothing but GM into VBE, and also the model will represent IB also, which is nothing but VBE by R pi. Okay, so therefore, in order to draw this hybrid pi model, now let us first consider our amplifier circuit. So the amplifier circuit is now drawn. It is of course redrawn by eliminating all the DC sources, because we are concerned with only the signal components in this. Okay, so here we have the source, VBE source, connected to base, and the collector resistor RC. So here we have the collector component, current component IC, which is nothing but GM into VBE, and here we have the emitter connected to ground. Okay, and the emitter component, that is IE, is equal to VBE by RE. The derivations we have seen in the previous session, you can just refer them. And then we need to connect this because VCC is short circuited in this. So we have to write this VBE voltage. It is between base and the emitter, and VCE also, which is between collector point. Okay, and then we still have the base current IB, base current IB. Okay, and this IB is equal to VBE by R pi, VBE by R pi. Okay, so now these many components we have mentioned in our circuit. What is that? First one is the VBE, which is nothing but the input, then VCE component, then IC current, collector current component, emitter current component, then IB base current component. So because all these are going to be included in the hybrid pi model. Okay. So therefore now with this we are going to draw the complete model. And also at the emitter node of this particular circuit. Okay, so where is the emitter node? This is the emitter node. Emitter node, and here we have the collector node, and this is the base node. Okay, so now we are writing some relations at the emitter node. Okay, so at the emitter node, what we have is the IE. Okay, it can be the sum of IB plus IC. See, now this is this particular derivation is done to show that how the IE is again equal to VBE by RB. Okay, so IB is equal to VBE by R pi plus, now IC we know this, GM into VBE. So this is equal to VBE by R pi, VBE R pi taken as a common factor, 1 plus GM into R pi. Okay, so in this above equation, so you can simply replace R pi. So we know that this R pi is equal to beta by GM. Okay, so now we will substitute this beta by GM here in this equation. So therefore now I am getting IE is equal to VBE by R pi into 1 plus GM into beta by GM. So we can cancel the GM components. So therefore emitter current component will be simply, it is VBE, small it is everywhere, VBE by R pi into 1 plus beta. So it can also be written as VBE by R pi by 1 plus beta, 1 plus beta. But there is a relation. So what is that relation between R pi and RE? R pi is equal to beta plus 1 into RE. Okay, therefore RE is equal to R pi by 1 plus beta. So now substituting this in the above equation, finally we are going to get the emitter current component IE is nothing but VBE divided by RE. Okay, so therefore whatever we have derived for IB and IC, okay, so that holds good because again we are getting IE as VBE by RE only. Therefore now we will draw the hybrid pi model. So the model has three terminals and the input resistance, and at the output side we have the current source and collector terminal, and here we have the emitter terminal, emitter base collector. So this resistance is input resistance R pi, and across this only we have this VBE plus minus, and this is the collector current IC, which is nothing but GM into VBE. So therefore this is what is our entire hybrid pi model. And here we can mention the currents. This is the base current IB and collector current IC and the emitter current component IE. Okay, so in the hybrid pi model, this you can consider as the input side of the transistor, which gives you input resistance R pi and VBE voltage, and at the output side, that is at the collector terminal, we have collector current IC, which is nothing but GM into VBE. So now, why it is a dependent source? Because it is voltage controlled current source. So that's why we are making use of a dependent current source. So as well as we have to mention the emitter current IE also at the emitter terminal. Okay. So now in this GM is equal to, what are the relations that we have used? GM is equal to IC by BT, as well as this R pi will be equal to beta by GM. So these are the important relations. So now slightly we can write in a different way also. That is, whatever this GM into VB is the current source, dependent current source. Okay, so this can be replaced by another component also. What is that another component is? In the previous hybrid pi model, that is in this model, so whatever GM into VB is there, this can be written as GM into VB is nothing but IB into R pi, IB into R pi. Okay, or this can be written as GM into R pi into VB, into IB, into IB. Okay, but GM into R pi is equal to beta this into IB. Okay, so we can now replace that dependent current source GM into VBE by beta into IB also. So therefore, by including this, we can redraw the same model. So we have the base terminal here. The only difference is now the dependent source is beta into IB, that's all, beta into IB. So remaining everything is same. We have the collector terminal and the emitter terminal is there. Okay, and here we are writing R pi. Okay, so now base current IB and the collector current here IC and here the emitter current IE. Okay. So this we can call it as an equivalent model. This is equivalent model for the previous hybrid pi model. That's where only the difference will be this beta into IB in place of GM into VB. And also here we need to mention the voltage VBE also between base and emitter terminal. Okay, so this is what is regarding the voltage gain and the hybrid pi model. Okay, so we will continue the other topics in the next session.